Hey, what's up, guys? This is Jason from Newmark. Today we're talking about the Mixtrak Pro 2. This is the refresh, more low-profile, sleeker model for control of Serato DJ Intro. All right, so the first section I want to cover today are the platters. The new low-profile platters also have a backlit LED behind them, and they're dual zone. So when you're playing a track, the scratch button engaged, you'll be able to scratch from the top of the platter, or the side, you can use it as a nudge to beat match. With the scratch button disengaged, the whole platter acts as the nudge. Directly below the platters, we have our transport controls. Sync, cue, play pause, and the stutter button. The cue will start and stop the track until you release the cue button. Now, Serato Intro and Serato DJ automatically set the first cue point for you. You can also move that cue point by grabbing the platter and setting it wherever you like. Now, when you press the play button with the cue button engaged, the track will continue to play. And obviously, pressing play pause will stop the track. Stutter also acts as a hot cue. It will jump back to the initial cue point and continue playing the track. Let's talk about some of the secondary functions using the shift button. With the shift button plus the sync, it's going to disengage the sync. So we have it on, shift plus sync turns it off. The secondary function of the cue is going to disregard that initial cue point or wherever it's set and jump back all the way to the beginning and reset the initial cue point to the beginning of the track. Next section we're going to talk about is the mixer. On the Mixtrak Pro 2, we have a standard crossfader. You can adjust the crossfader curve within the Serato DJ or Serato Intro software. Above the crossfader, we have our deck and our master gain controls. Deck B, deck A, and the master gain, which is the master output of the Mixtrak Pro 2. Above those, we have independent three-band EQ, treble, mid, and bass. Below the EQ is the cue button. The cue button is used to send the mix into the headphones. With the cue engaged, we can now hear the oncoming mix in the headphones. Use the cue mix button to adjust the blend from the headphone output to the master output. Above that is the cue gain, which will just increase or decrease the volume of all output through the headphones. Below the cue mix section is the browser control. The browser control will allow you to scroll through the software without using your mouse or trackpad. To select a track you want, use the encoder and then press the load A button to load to A or load B to load to B. To scroll through your crates or playlist, press the back button. We can now jump through different crates. Once we find the crate we want, press down on the browser encoder and now we can cycle through that list. Directly below the three-band EQ are your cue buttons. Use the cue mix knob to blend between what's playing in your headphones and the actual output of the Mixtrak Pro 2. Above that is the cue gain to increase or decrease the volume of what's being played in your headphones. Above the platter is the tempo fader. The tempo fader is used to slow down or speed up a track. Above the fader are your pitch bend minus and your pitch bend plus button. These are also used to slow down and speed up the track. Let's use them to beat match now. Sounded pretty good. You can also beat match using the tempo faders. The pitch bend buttons also have secondary functions. The pitch bend minus button plus the shift is key lock. With key lock turned off, we'll adjust the tempo and adjust the pitch as well. Now we can turn the key lock on and adjust the tempo without adjusting the pitch. If you've upgraded to a Serato DJ software, the pitch bend plus button will also have a secondary function, which is range. The range will cycle between 8, 16, and 50% of the value of the tempo fader. On the back of the unit, you'll find an RCA output for connection to a club mixer or to powered speakers, as well as your USB connection for plugging into your computer. One of the best new features of the Mixtrak Pro 2 are the 8 backlit LED pads. These pads can be used to sample, trigger hot cues, effects, as well as your loop controls. To engage these modes, press down the shift button and press pad 1 for looping, 2 for samples, 3 for hot cues. So let's talk about some of the loop controls. On the MixTrack Pro 2, we have 4 dedicated pads for manual looping. Above that, we have 4 pads for auto looping. On the bottom, we have loop in, loop out, re-loop, cut your loop in half, or double loop. Let's check it out. So, loop in, loop out. You can hear that's off just a little bit, so press the loop out again, stops the beat, use the platter to adjust. Now we can see that it's perfect. We can use the fourth pad here to cut the loop in half. Re-loop jumps out of the loop. And using the shift button plus the fourth pad, we'll double loop. Above the 4 bottom pads are your auto loops. Use the shift button and press any one of them. So you have auto 1, auto 2, auto 4, and a 16. And these also can be cut in half or doubled using the shift button. And those are your loop controls. So let's talk about the second mode of the pads, sample mode. To engage sample mode, press down shift and the pad marks sample. These 4 pads now will trigger the samples within the software. I have a kick, DJ horn, an uplifter, and then another sample. Let's use these samples to transition into the next track. I'm going to use my auto loop feature because it's still available no matter which mode you're in. My auto loop. I've got an uplifter here. And it makes for a seamless transition using samples. The third mode of the lower pads is cue mode, or hot cues. To engage hot cues, press down the shift button and the pad labeled Q. You can see that all 3 pads are already illuminated. That's because the hot cues are already loaded. We've got 1 at the intro of the track, 1 when the kick comes in, and 1 when there's a little more music behind it. Now we can juggle the cues, and then press the play button when you want to keep playing. You can juggle from the other deck. Pretty much do whatever you want with hot cues, it's all up to you. So mess around and see what you come up with. The first 3 pads are used to turn on and off the effects. The fourth pad is used to tap the tempo instead of using the multiplier knob to adjust the rate at which the effect is being applied. So let's listen to what the effects sound like. Here we've got a reverb. Adjust the parameter knob. You can change the effect by holding down the shift button. Phaser. And here we can use the multiplier to adjust the rate at which the effect is being applied. And that's the effects section. All right, guys, that wraps it up for this video. Thanks for checking it out. As mentioned before, the MixTrack Pro ships with Serato Intro software, but you can upgrade to the full version of Serato DJ at serato.com.